As the third school term begins today, the traffic police have revealed a staggering death toll of 239 school-going children killed in road accidents since the beginning of this year. According to traffic police spokesperson Michael Kananura, the fatalities occurred in the past two school terms, highlighting the alarming danger school children face on the roads. According to the police, 872 children were killed in road crashes throughout 2023, while 650 lost their lives in 2022. The victims, aged between 5 and 18, were largely from urban and rural areas. Kananura revealed this during a security press conference held at the Uganda Police Headquarters in Naguru today.
We are all aware that our schools have started today for third term, and maybe also to update the country on the death that we normally register involving school-going children. In the year of 2022, we lost 650 pupils between the age of 5 to 18. In 2023, we lost 872, those ones are between the age of 5 to 18. And this year, 2024, half year in the period of 6 months, so far 239 school-going children have perished in crashes.
He urged the parents, schools and transport providers to prioritize road safety measures to protect children traveling to and from schools. He emphasized the need for children to use designated taxis and border stages, travel in groups while walking, and always board registered taxis or motorcycles. For parents in urban centers, Kananura advised providing helmets for children who use borders as primary mode of transport.
Children below the age of 12 must be accompanied on these motorcycles. Ensure helmets for pupils and cyclists. Parents that give your children or pupils to these cyclists, you have to ensure that they have helmets for both the children to use while they go to school, even when they come back.
The Presidential Advisor on Environment and Sanitation, Professor Gilbert Bukenya, together with officials from National Environmental Management Authority, NEMA, today inspected the Lubiji wetland and demarcated the wetland boundaries. The operation to evict unlawful settlers in this wetland is set to commence this week on Thursday, starting from Kawala. Professor Bukenya has urged encroachers on this wetland to vacate peacefully, saying that no one occupying the wetland unlawfully shall be spared.
This pillar, which will go all the way up to Mintiana Road, yes, and all the way to Chengera. And this time, this area will go all the way up to Waise, beyond Waise, to make sure that if you see this pillar, you, the citizens of Uganda, don't go, don't do a business.
The Deputy RCC for Nansana Municipality, Barnabas Matovu, said that efforts to sensitize the locals have been carried. Therefore, the community is expected to comply.
Vanquished areas, like he's mentioning, Lugogo. Maybe it's meaning where there is like a forest mall, Lugogo. Those ones were already declared vanquished areas through the cabinet, through parliament. But those which are still under the map of the Wetland Management Department and the NEMA, being shown as wetlands, those ones will be fully restored.
The Public Accountants Examinations Board President Ronald Mutumba today released examination results for 6,121 for Certified Public Accountants CPA who sat the examinations last month. Out of 6,121 candidates who sat for the exams, only 1,896 passed, accounting for 31% pass.
Therefore, for those who have completed the course, this ceremony represents a major milestone in your professional accountancy journey, which I hope will lead to a long, impactful and fulfilling career.
CPA Professor Laura A. Orobia, Chairperson Public Accountants Examination Board, attributed the poor performance to lack of adequate preparations by candidates who sat the examinations.
We have noted with concern the poor performance in some subjects in these August 2024 examinations. We believe that, among other things, students had not prepared well, would therefore like to call upon candidates intending to attempt the December 2024 examinations to intensify their preparations for better outcomes.
Speaking during the release of the examination results at Skies Hotel in Nagaru today, the Chief Executive Officer for the Institute of Certified Public Accountants of Uganda, Derek Nkaja, cautioned the public about the personnel they employ as accountants. He reiterated that a true accountant must be registered by the Certified Public Accountants Board.
Professional accountancy board. And our mandate is to ensure that the standards of accountancy are developed, promoted, regulated within the country, and also to ensure that we have a critical number of accountants who become professional and their conduct is prescribed